The following video may contain sensitive topics. The views and opinions of the presenter to these are plainly his own. Furthermore, any and all views and opinions of the presenter do not, in any way, reflect the views, opinions, statements, and advocacies of his personal contacts, his family, his affiliations, and his profession. While the presenter makes a commitment that all content is original, he is obliged to cite references or acknowledge resources mentioned or used in the production of this video. This disclaimer is also written in the description below.
I am Ian Reñon, an independent alternative media practitioner, among other things. I'm not sure if it's going to be spontaneous prud banter, pero I'm really thinking about tweaking a bit this format. Kasi ayoko naman din kasi na puro na lang puro unedited videos. It's not that I'm a bit conscious about my videos, pero minsan naisip ko lang din na just have to do it. So with that said, it's a brood banter. Tara, kape tayo.
Absolute struggle
sometimes.
Don't move.
Now, pagpasensya niya na ako, medyo shaky kasi the table that I'm in here in McDonald's, it's a bit flimsy, pero that will do. Now, McDonald's, bakit ka nag-McDo ngayon, Ian? Una sa lahat, I didn't have a full breakfast in Intrepid HQ. And, I might as well, mag-bike na lang din ako kasi ayoko naman din na ma-ano ko. And bakit McDo? I mean, with all the BS that's happening right now in the world, maraming nagsasabi na may sinusuportahan ng McDo. I don't give a shit. I really don't. Gutom ako. Okay? Gutom ako. I don't really care kung I don't really care kung may sinusuportahan yung McDo sa isang in a certain country. If you don't know what I mean, check out the last two episodes. The latest two episodes of the Intrepid podcast so that you would know. Pero yun nga, I'm not here for that bullshit, okay? Gutom ako, I need some coffee, kaya nag-McDo ako. Tapos ang usapan, okay? Now, kaya ako nag-brood banter ngayon kasi I was just thinking about this concept called imposter syndrome. Now, in a nutshell, imposter syndrome means you're being someone that you're not. And in a lot of things, nakakaranas din ako ng ganun. Meron akong video dati tungkol sa encyclical ni Pope Francis na ang title ay Fratelli Tutti. Check nyo na lang. Two-part series siya. So, baka yan ako, i-playlist ko na lang, bahala na. But mga kababayan, sometimes old wounds just open, kaya I'm really compelled to ride a bike today para lang ma-regulate din yung mga emotions ko. Kasi sa totoo lang mga kababayan, I'm still struggling with the fact that the people that I'm going to talk about are still have those festering wounds. And I'm not gonna name names, pero yung mga kilala ko, they absolutely know who am I talking about. They absolutely know who am I talking about. Kaya I don't really wanted to give too much information about it, pero yun nga, kasi there's this person who has just published a book about how being a man, how to be a man. And from the reviews that I've been reading about that book, okay naman siya. But then again, may mga nabasa din ako na criticism tungkol sa expertise or ano niya. Pero kasi, let's just say na these two people have some kind of bad blood. or one of the people has an axe to grind. Pero kasi nakakalungkot lang eh, mga kababayan. Nakakalungkot lang na I still have to talk about this. Kasi yung criticism kasi nung ano, nung... by the way, I know both of these people. So again, I'm not naming names, pero kilala ko pareho to. That person who is criticizing the other person, sabi niya, wala naman siyang expertise, wala siyang ano, wala siyang PhD and all that shit. Okay. Aminado naman din yung ano, yung kini-criticize niya na ganoon. Pero ang rebut niya eh parang what's the point? Lahat naman tayo may mga pagkukulang, lahat naman tayo may mga discrepancies, lahat naman tayo may mga ano, mga hindi pagkakaano, pagkakaintindi ganyan. And you know, it's ano, it's the beauty of it. It's the beauty of living our lives. Na these things happen. It is ugly. Yes, it is unfortunate na nangyari to sa dalawang kakilala ko. By the way, that guy is ano, the guy who just wrote the book just got married. Kaya okay lang. And the other person who is criticizing that guy, ano siya? Mental health professional na siya. So ako, wala naman akong problema sa kanila pareho eh. Nagkataon lang na ano, na ang masasabi ko lang regarding this matter is that it all started in 2019 noong nung kasagsaga ng ano, nung Pachamama incident sa Roma. Nalulungkot lang talaga ako kasi napakalaki ng potential nitong ano, nitong mga nitong dalawang taong to. Kasi perhaps I would also write to the author kung bakit ganun na lang yung ano, yung criticism sa kanya. Kasi the person criticizing him is actually in a dark place at this point. Kaya naiintindihan ko din yung ano niya, yung mindset niya. Ang ano ko lang eh, I don't wanna talk that much about it, pero I'm just giving you a context about that ano. But why do I ano, why do I talk about imposter syndrome? Bakit ko nire-relate sa kwento na to yung imposter syndrome? Kasi I understand where these two are coming from. Kasi kahit ako, may imposter syndrome ako. The author has no ano, has no the author has no academic degrees. Yes. The mental health professional who criticizes that guy nagsisimula pa lang siya sa ano niya, sa pag-aaral niya, pero marami siyang struggles and unfortunately it's church related, kaya hindi ko rin siya sinisisi sa mga bagay na yun. Although it's ano, it's upsetting na ano, ganun yung mindset niya, pero gets ko kasi ayaw ko sabihing been there done that, pero I can definitely resonate. How about me? I have this my imposter syndrome is more on being genuine in all the things that I have been doing. Na kumbaga I'm trying to be as ano, as authentic as possible. At kung may maririnig kayong parang medyo mahangin, pasensya na mga kababayan. It's already November and kapag per months nagsisimula ng ano, nagsisimula ng lumakas ang hangin, and it's thanks to Amihan. So that's that. And also it seems that since I suspect myself to be autistic a few years ago, nararamdaman ko rin sa sarili ko na baka mali yung suspecha ko. Kasi although I do have these suspicions, eh parang ayoko naman din na pangunahan ng mga mental health professionals. Kumbaga, I just wanted to know myself. That's all. That's actually all that I wanted to ano, to do. So, ayun. But whether you're writing a book or getting into something, ano, getting to something that would help ano, our society when it comes to their well-being, or you're just trying to know yourself and who you are. The fact of the matter is, nakakaranas tayo ng ano, ng imposter syndrome paminsan-minsan. Nakakaranas tayo ng ano, ng pakiramdam na medyo hindi ko ano, hindi ko gusto or hindi ko na na-appreciate ang sarili ko kasi I really don't belong to ano, to where I am, whether it's a profession, where it's a whether it's a diagnosis, whether it's the things that you have done that are very much successful in your ano, in your perspective. Nakakaranas tayo ng ganyan. And I guess the best way for us to ano, to combat imposter syndrome is to take care of ourselves. Do some wellness stuff. Sa ngayon, eto, nagbabike ako kasi parang na ano ko lang din, na pansin ko lang din yung ano, napansin ko lang din talaga na other than dopamine, other than ano, than having that dose of dopamine, and perhaps I'm gonna talk about it further down the line, this is the next best thing to therapy. I can definitely say that this is the next best thing to therapy kasi nothing beats it, nothing beats therapy. Kaya lang in this economy parang nakapanghinayang lang din ano, na mag-therapy ka na sobrang mahal sa ngayon ah. But you know, wala akong masamang tinapay sa kanilang dalawa. In fact, ano, masaya ako na ano, sa mga ano nila, sa mga career nila and all that shit. Sa akin lang, I only hope that time would heal wounds if the person who has been injured would allow their wounds to be healed. Yun lang. So, to those two persons that I've been ano, talking about in this video, I would just like to say na you're doing great in what you're doing, and I hope that whatever your endeavors are, you would succeed in it. As long as it's for the common good. So, ang akin lang, kundi man kayo ano, kundi man kayo magbate or kundi man kayo magano mag mag-usap or whatever, I just hope that I won't lose very close contacts in the cause that I have been dealing with just because of what happened 4 years ago. So yeah, yun lang naman sa akin. Cheers. So, sobrang lakas ng hangin na lumipad yung lid dun sa ano, sa basurahan. But anyway, now that my coffee's gone and I fully had the breakfast, next thing in my list is to go nearby to Ayala Malls Vermosa kasi nasa McDo Vermosa ako. So para ma-check ko rin kasi kakabukas lang over the weekend eh, napakalapit lang sa Intrepid HQ. So might as well kesa naman magbukbuk ako sa bahay. So with all that said, this is Intrepid Ian Rinyon reminding you to at all times, now more than ever, be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Until then, look alive, stay alive, be kind to yourself and to each other. If you're a cyclist, please lang, don't be that six-letter word. Magsuot kayo ng helmet. And lalo na kapag nagbabike kayo, kahit malapit lang, helmet pa rin. That's important. And as always, thank you for watching. From here in MacDove Hermosa. See you next time. Ian out. Bonus clip. Nandito ako sa Ayala Malls Vermosa. This is just just a few minutes walk mula sa entrance ng Vermosa na pinapasukan ng mga siklista. And that's the yan yung unang display nila sa opening. That's gonna last until early January, I think, 2024. So siguro pagdating na ng Pasko, baka magano ako dito. Tumambay ako dito. sana lang may extra time ako para makapag tambay dito kahit gabi. I would cycle much better sa gabi kaysa sa umaga. Kaya I'm definitely looking forward to that. Well, uwi na ako. Baka hanapin ako ni Mother Superior sa Intrepid HQ.